I suppose you could see the use of an icon as having three distinct forms. You have the icon, first of all, as part of the decoration of a church. Decoration is not quite the right word because it's not just something on the wall. The icon in the church represents the presence of Christ and the saints right in the midst. So when you go into an Orthodox church, you're surrounded by these living images, these active images of holy life, and you're actually brought into a new place, a new space. So the icons there serve very much to do what Orthodox worship is supposed to do, relocate you, take you from earth to heaven. But the second use is that they're often carried around in procession. You might have a procession around a town or the outside of a church. It's an act of blessing. You take them across the fields in Russian farms in the old days. You'd bless the environment, the town, the farm, the home, the church, by walking around with the icon, again representing this continuity of divine action, divine gift, which protects and blesses the whole human environment. But also, you'd expect to have an icon in the household. And that's one of the things that's become most distinctive, again, in Orthodox spirituality over the centuries. The icon is something which makes the home itself a sacred space. You have an icon in the corner of every Orthodox household, and usually several on the walls, but one particular in the icon corner, which in Russian was called the red corner or the beautiful corner, because the words are the same in Russian. That's the corner where God's beauty is most to be seen. And in 19th century Russia, and earlier than that, there's evidence of a sort of folk practice that if people were being very loose in their talk or unkind in their talk, somebody might say, "We ought to take the icons out," just as a reminder that you can't say these things in the presence of the holy image. So it's a reminder in the household that you are still under the eye of God. You're still called to the same kind of Christian discipleship as you would be anywhere else. So the icon is personal, it's corporate, it's something which has a role in the liturgy, because at various points in the liturgy the priest will walk around and wave the incense in front of the icons. Everyone going into the church will kiss at least some of the icons. So that's the basis of it. But that devotion to the images spills over, it becomes something which is used to bless the immediate environment, and it's something which is used to sanctify everyday life.